Dear listeners of Can't Get Right, you know you can find the latest 15 episodes of this podcast on iTunes, Spotify, YouTube, or anywhere else that you find podcasts. But did you know that you can find the entire archive of episodes on demand only at gasdigitalnetwork.com? That's right, over 400 hours of Can't Get Right, plus access to all the other podcasts available at Gas Digital. Some of them much better podcasts. Just pause this podcast right now and go to subscribe at gasdigitalnetwork.com and use promo code Kurt, K-U-R-T, and get $1.50 off membership plus a 14-day trial. Plus, as a member, you get access to the episodes a few days before they go out on iTunes. So don't miss out on this great offer. Go to gasdigitalnetwork.com and use promo code Kurt and get the whole collection. Plus, you know, better shows than mine. I'll say it.
Fill her up.
You're listening to the Gas Digital Network.
Yeah, I know. Because I can't get right. This is cutthroat. This burns as words pop from a snub nose. This Kurt Metzger and not give a fuck mode. Because I can't get right. Because I can't get right. Yeah. You're listening to Can't Get Right.
This is Can't Get Right with me, Kurt Metzger. My special guest, America's sweetheart. You know America's sweetheart, Dan Soder.
Hi. Hey, America. Bye.
Dan Soder, who's just getting over COVID-19. Is that true? You had it.
That is true. I was infected with the COVID-19 for the past 12 days.
Now, how long have you been a spy for the deep state who's faking the story about COVID? Go ahead.
I was approached in 2002 at the University of Arizona in Tucson. They said I wasn't ready for the farm. But they said I was ready enough to smoke bad weed and be an okay comedian.
Now,
to inject myself into the social structure.
And did they say anything about revealing the truth of the flat or convex earth, or do you still have to keep that under wraps?
Well, to get off, as we call the base, you have to go through a long series of tunnels and Jeopardy questions. People don't realize that. That's actually
the Jeopardy questions.
Yeah, Alex Trebek was brought in to condition us. If you have the right amount of knowledge, you can leave the flat earth or the base, as we call it.
Wow, the base. So wait, yeah. The base is people. What is the base?
We have different levels of worlds. I just want to keep chasing this to see if I can.
Yeah, this is actually becoming more compelling than anything I was going to.
Yeah, there's a lot of talk about. There's a lot of QAnon free agents right now. So you can just start spinning some shit and hope that they grab onto it.
Did you see the lady? Hold on, Joe. Let me text you the article. Because I just tweeted because it made me laugh so fucking hard. This article title about Jewish space lasers.
Dude, Jewish space lasers. Big year for them. If you weren't investing in GameStop or Jewish space lasers, you missed out.
Well, it turns out, and I should have known. Hold on. Let me send this to sweet, sweet Joey. Okay, here's from New York. GOP Congresswoman blamed wildfires on secret Jewish space laser.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's hilarious.
Yeah.
So I was like, wouldn't that be a better like Star Wars Episode 9 Jewish space lasers? Like,
there he goes. There's something that we cannot deal with.
Or really, Jews. Pretty much any of the episodes could be called Jewish space lasers. That's how I'm going to call Star Wars from now on.
I heard that was the working title of the entire series.
Yeah, Jewish space lasers.
When George Lucas was writing it, they go, George, we can't fund anything called Jewish space laser.
Okay. So this guy, Jonathan Chait, who I've seen before. He's like a guy that signed the liberal free speech document in Harper's.
Yeah.
Of like, we're liberals and we're concerned about, and then they got all in trouble and some of them had to take back their signature.
Like, dude, that's great when they're like, we're standing up for them, we're in trouble, we're going to step down. Okay.
By the way, dippy fucking New York liberal media people, if it's gotten to the point that you're writing your pussy ass letter to Harper's, it's already too late, you dumb shits.
Yeah.
You should have defended the comedians, the ones on the front lines fighting this war for you.
When
the
you
Dane
write...
Chappelle's, the Daniel Tots's.
When you have to write that letter of like
Bill Burp, the people on the floor.
Bill Burp, it sounds like you're doing what are those trash, you know, the trash pash kids, not the garbage.
No, it's gonna
kids,
be
trash pail kids. You're doing like the trash pail kids of a comedy with Bill.
You know
Burp.
What it is? It's when we do our special stand up against comedy for pussies. Mm-hmm. we're gonna. That's because I like writing fucking up people's names as like a bit in all the sketches. Like with Joe Biden, my favorite thing is to say Jocko Biden.
Dude,
So the flubs
that you guys write for Joe Biden is, I was texting with you, it's one of my favorite things. It's fucking hilarious.
Roll the gain down a little. Now here we go. Now the bullshit starts. The gain's too high. Wow. Well, is it interesting? I bring up Jewish space lasers and now the gain's too high.
They start getting edited. For people who don't know, that's podcast talk for one of the
mainstream
producers. Possibly.
Because Joey and Bobby are typical mainstream media.
Kurt's getting silenced. You guys are watching Kurt get silenced as he brings up.
And you just stand by.
Yeah. And I'll tell you this. I'm such a deep state crisis actor that I cannot break.
Right. A Christer. It's a problem.
Okay, that's going to be what I'm doing, traveling Christian theater.
So this article is about Marjorie Taylor Greene. So yeah. She didn't fucking say Jewish space lasers. Okay?
MTG?
No, all she said was, it's possible that ex-Governor Jerry Brown, PSE&G, the electrical company,
yes,
and Rothschild Inc. maybe are involved with lasers from space that cause forest fires. So see. Don't you feel like an idiot?
Yeah, that's like a traveling call in the NBA. That's four steps to get somewhere. You're like, okay, so
yes, this traveling. Company, that's exactly that's traveling. The best way to put it. Her reasoning is traveling. The thing is
traveling.
Nobody's going to read her wall of text. They're just going to. Oh, that's Jewish crazy. Space lasers. So the reason I think that they say Jewish space lasers is because he goes, the Rothschild family has featured heavily in anti-Semitic conspiracy theories since at least. So what this is the first knee-jerk thing. It was already crazy. You didn't have to add Jewish to it. And make it like it's anti-Semitic. And by the way, not liking the Rothschilds like is like a lizard people thing. You don't have to be anti-Semitic for that. I agree.
It's with the Rothschilds?
It's like George or the Koch brothers or George Soros or Sheldon Adelson. Depending on your political party, you have
it's just the spice that you put on a fucking crazy thing. You hear
everybody has a different rich Jew that's responsible.
You go, ooh, which you have like your Jew cabinet, and you're like, do you want to use some Soros or some Rothschild on this one?
Yeah. So that was him putting, that's him projecting his little fucking New York his New York Jew bullshit. But she was already crazy. That's already crazy to the other thing I just said. You don't need to put an extra. So the reason I'm saying it's disappointing is I want to laugh at that. I'm like, oh, she said Jew lasers from space. And she didn't. You fucking said that. Just leave what she said alone. It was already funny.
Have you ever done that with someone where you hear someone tells you a funny story and you don't know that they punched it up? So you see the person that it's about and you're like, oh, and then you said this.
What about when Big J does that and he doesn't know that he punched it up?
that's exactly what I'm talking about, where Jay will be like, yeah, and then he walked in and said this, and then I'll see the guy and be like, dude, Jay was telling me about when you walked in and said this, and he's like, I didn't say
that. Dude, Jay does it epically, and like I almost don't want to know the truth after Jay's done with his journalism.
Jay does like a 60 minute spin on it.
He'll tell you he does it too, because he's done it with from this movie Menace to Society, where when the Korean guy gets shot, when they hey, give him the same fucking sandwich, and the guy's like, and Jay was remembering it as the guy going, same fucking sandwich. That's how Jay remembered it.
Yeah,
a California accent that was not Asian at all.
Yeah, Jay punches up everything in his head. Everything. Dude, I saw
some guys think Brandon Schwab. I don't know how he says his last name. You know him?
I think he nailed it.
It's Rogan's buddy.
Yeah.
I know him a little. I don't know him very well.
I've met him once. Jay had him on the bonfire. Actually, I met him a couple times. He was on the bonfire.
So.
And I went on his podcast.
Made a clip.
Brian Callen before that thing.
I didn't see his hour. Wow. So you have. So it's fair to say you have an extensive history with Brandon Schwab.
I would probably say I have a deep history with him.
I don't know him really well. I was on his podcast. We went to school together.
He is from where I grew up. That's not a joke. He grew up in the same town I am.
And he knows my mom, Trish Soder. So
he goes, this is going to be crazy for you. He saved me from a snake bite, 7th grade.
He almost became my new dad this much.
We were paired off in a camping trip.
Hold on. I'm going to forget why.
Yeah.
I didn't watch his hour, okay? But apparently there's a part where he's talking about an Asian guy fixing like an ankle injury. And he was doing it as like, oh, your ankle so fucking.
He Miyagi'd him?
He Miyagi'd him, and then somebody who I guess doesn't like him made a clip of this of him saying, and then the guy just talks like a normal guy with no. So he entirely edited in.
And this guy has public clips of him.
Yeah, talking. The Asian guy that he's just Asian. He's from California or something. But that's a common, I'm not trying to single out sweet Brandon Schwab, but Jay did that with the same fucky sandwich, the same thing where he just remembered.
Yeah, but that is so fucking funny.
I'm not calling them racist for it, because I
just think it's funny just to give someone an over-the-top accent when it's absolutely not needed.
Well, it's like a thing to just juice up this. It's like giving this Jewish space lasers thing.
Dude, I'm going to start that's
what this is basically. Jewish space lasers is this guy's eye roll at this crazy person.
Yeah. Where he's like, oh, she said crazy shit. Also.
Oh, great. It's always the Jews. It's completely that thing. And, you know, if a few Jews are paranoid, you can't really historically blame them.
Because yeah, they have a history of being right about their paranoia.
Yeah, like they're really annoying. I'm not saying this guy was trying to be like, I think he was trying to be funny by saying Jewish, because it is funny to say Jewish space. But what's upsetting, if you Google that, all the articles are saying, instead of repeating what she actually said, they're all saying his joke about it.
Yeah.
Saying Jewish space. And
that's how I heard it. I didn't even know when I heard about it, it got to me. It was already.
It's like Al Gore invented the internet.
Yeah.
Al Gore never said he invented the internet.
I didn't. I invented Jewish space lasers. Why won't Jewish anyone space give lasers. Me? They're called heat beams.
And
why won't anyone listen to me?
Heat beams. Let's be honest. If there are lasers from space that cause forest fires, who's going to make those?
The Chinese.
Not Jews.
Nah, Chinese or Jews. Chinese get into wild shit.
Are Chinese that ahead with lasers? I know they're ahead with certain things.
I would say yes, Kurt. I would say yes.
Can I tell you, and this could just be my present, if I have a space laser made that I know Jews made or was made in China, I would take the Jew laser.
You would, if you had to compare.
And it's not because I don't think that Chinese people could build a quality laser.
What if the Chinese...
I just know the Chinese government, they don't have...
What
their
if the
standards
Chinese space
are not
laser,
that high.
That's what I was just going to ask. What if the Chinese space laser might be a little iffy, much better of a bargain?
Well, how bad do I need to burn this forest down? That's really what you're getting.
How much work do you want to do?
You're getting to the heart of it.
Yeah.
It's just what I envision. And like I said, I don't know a lot about the space laser industry, but I imagine like a jeweler, like I'm going to make this extra precise laser for, you know?
Yeah, versus the Chinese, like, it burn.
The Chinese just shopping it out to some Vietnamese.
Yeah, I don't want to shove up that Chinese space laser.
So I'm not trying to shove up this accent.
He might be like, I actually went to Stanford. I don't know why you're speaking that way.
No, the guy talks like that.
He does?
He talks like.
Yeah, man, I tried to sit through some of it, man, and it was.
Through what? The Chinese guy talking?
No, it was special.
Oh.
And it was like, you know.
Oh, why? Why would you?
Because we have friends.
Against him, but I was, you're your friend. Oh.
No, we have friends. You know how comics are like, dude, you got to watch this person special. Everyone. You know, we used to do
I would think I would watch it more. If it's somebody's my friend, but I don't have nothing against him at all. I know him just the tiniest bit.
Okay, you got a special tour.
I think it would be,
you got a special too early, and I think it's like.
Yeah, so I think it would be easier for me to watch that than someone who's a friend watching it.
Yeah, but you know, this as a comic, when there's a new special that comes out of someone that you're not friends with, you get a call from someone like a Joe DeRosa, and you play a nice comedy rodeo where you see how long.
We're
going
to get to something about Joe DeRosa too. You just reminded me.
Like,
yeah, exactly. I don't know anybody that would do that.
Put out, like that Dr. Ken special, I don't think I made it. Fucking, I think I bucked at 7 minutes.
I like Dr. Ken too.
I'm sure these people are very sweet.
That's why I'd have a hard time if it's not good. I have a hard time watching it. But
I mean, Schaub's, when I met him, he's been super nice. But yeah, I mean,
comedy-wise, I wouldn't expect shit from it because I'm like, oh, isn't he a UFC guy? That's
yeah,
a comedian. It's like the Gronk hosting that.
Dude, did we watch the Gronk on?
I was
the
there. Bonfire.
Oh yeah.
That's when I was there last, was the Gronk.
Yeah,
and I'm like,
then we interviewed his girlfriend and we're like, we watched his comedy special and it's fucking brutal.
What did she say?
She's like, yeah, there's a couple people got him to do that shouldn't have done it. All these people,
everybody
try to do,
they can do it. They all think everyone. They can do it.
Did you ever see that Alana Glazer one on Amazon?
I would have thought she could do it before I would have thought the Gronk could do it.
Me too.
You know? No, she should stick to her day job making Jew lasers.
You don't know that. She could use a much thriftier Chinese laser. With a guy who talks like this.
She looked like
I actually designed it in a laboratory.
She looked like she was in good shape dancing around to that fucking Sex With Me song in the beginning.
I mean, that was going to be my intro from HBO special, so I was a little bummed she took it.
You were going to come out and
shake my ass.
Sex with me. Oh, so amazing.
Yeah, I was going to dance real big. And then they're going to be like, damn, Dan just shook his booty.
Yeah, that's such like a nod. You've got no. But she's like a improv something.
Yeah, I mean, I think no, like.
Stand up, everybody. It's its own thing. That
when you look back to like, you know, like 2010 to 2020, there's going to be a lot of novelty comedy. I think that's just what you need to call it. That's just what it is.
It's these Reggie Watts has a musical thing that you could probably get through. Jay summed up because Reggie Watts is like, it's not the music part is kind of good. Like his,
it's
his,
great.
Yeah.
It's like, catchy like, as shit.
And I would listen to it. It's the thing. He's not very good at writing lyrics. That's why it's comedy.
Yeah.
It's like, he's a good musician that writes not good lyrics. So it has to be comedy. Jay does it. He goes, I got my pen and my paper and my pen and my paper. And my, he does like, Jay's one of the best impressionists of.
He can mimic comedy to the point that one of the first episodes of The Bonfire, he was just doing a, you know, like something, an act, like a black act that he would have heard at the Laugh House.
Right.
And he just had this one line where he goes, now cut it right there, DJ. Now that motherfucker's talking about busting up inside a bitch. Now you can't be coming inside this bitch. I know this bitch with some kids. She got some badass kids. But just the way so fast. I was like, dude, that was the perfect mimic of a Def Jam.
Yeah, he was always great at that. And he doing like a comedian impression where he's not saying any words. He's just mimicking their beats. Yeah.
He's one of the ones that you watch that we love to watch specials with because he can just fucking break it down so fast. Yeah. And I've watched a lot of novelty comedy with DeRosa and Big J.
Yeah, well, we used to call it the hour challenge, but I don't know if they adopted the term the hour challenge. And it was just like, we just see if we can get through somebody's hour. And and then when somebody goes, I'm out, we have to turn it off.
Yeah. Yeah. That's what I was referring to.
Sometimes
as the
I've gotten through and I was like, oh, I didn't think they were going to get me at the hour. I'm like, that was a good hour. I'll tell somebody.
When you're like, pleasantly.
I'll write to them. Like, I go, listen, we did the hour challenge and I went through this great hour because normally we get through 5 minutes of the hour challenge.
Yeah, you don't want to watch anyone's. It's hard watching people you usually normally knows hour, but someone you don't know that you don't even, you're not even sure about. That's
oh, you mean brutal. Like because they're your peer?
I've watched a couple hours where I'm like, you know. But then there's some people that you put it on and it's like, I watched Sam Morril's hour, his latest one, and I was like, damn, it's over. That was an impressive.
Oh, I want to see that. I haven't seen his hour.
Yeah, his rooftop one. It's great.
Well, he's a good comic.
Yeah, him and Norman.
Like, well, I just try to support white males. So.
Oh wow. Yeah.
So that's why Brandon Schwab's cool.
Yeah, because he's a white male. I get it. As a deep state actor, I need to do anyone that's in the Lizard Clan. So. Right.
That's why you're trying to destroy us with transgenderism from the inside out.
Yes, I'm trying to frog flip you. I'm trying to frog you. I'm trying to get
you're trying to slowly boil us until we don't know, and then we're all trans. All right, wait, Joe.
You nailed my theory. What if I just had to get off the podcast right now after saying that? I'm like, all right,
great. Okay, I gotta go. Oh my god, yeah, you just it feed cuts. wait, I want to. So Joe DeRosa, somebody else texted me this from his Instagram.
Yeah.
Did you know Joey DeRosa's getting into the sandwich game?
Dude, he's been in the sandwich game. I have a magnet on my fridge that's Joey Rose's sandwich place. I look at it every time I go there.
Is this, he does this with the stand? Okay, so this is his new.
He has a menu of sandwiches.
But where are they selling them?
From the stand. You can order them during the day.
So that's where Joey Rose is. So Joe is, boy, I always wonder because he always had those hats on. And that was because he was going to be a sandwich guy.
Yeah, you basically saw like Bruce Wayne become Batman.
Can you see this picture of Joe DeRosa comedy here, Joey, in the little circle? Can we embiggen that just to take a good look at Joey DeRosa?
With his sandwich face?
I want to see
that sandwich face.
Look at the hat.
I want to try those sandwiches.
Is that, yeah. He looks like a guy who has a Netflix show called like, That's a Fucking Good Sandwich. What are those?
He also looks like a guy that just got arrested by Interpol in Germany. We got him in Munich. He was there. He was at an Apple store in Munich, and this is his picture.
So Joey DeRosa, so when I last saw him at Moon Tower, and we would go to eat, you know, Austin's got all this good shit to eat, and he kept going to Jimmy John's. Like, hey, you want to go to this place? And he goes, I think I'm going to go to Jimmy John's. He said he was going to Jimmy John's three nights in a row. And I'm like, is Jimmy John's that fucking good? There's no way, right?
No.
I was like, what if it turns out they are? Like Jimmy John's.
DeRosa had like this, he's always had these like eight sandwiches that he would talk about making.
Wait, hold on. Before he ever became a sandwich man.
Yeah.
Before he became a sandwich guy, he was always talking about sandwiches he'd like to one day release.
The Scrolls of DeRosa.
Can we put that sandwich back, Joey? I want to look at DeRosa's sandwich. That sounds dirty. Show me your sandwich, bro.
Show him your meat sandwich.
Okay, what is this? This is called the really the really fat kid, really shaming.
Shame.
It's a deep fried.
As a lizard deep fake.
Yes, that's
crisis a deep, actor.
Wait. That's yes. Here's Joe's at. Yes. I imagine like the Carvel guy. It's a deep fried hash brown.
The rose is
peanut butter and jelly.
That's what it is.
And yes, it rules. It sounds like pure shit.
Why? Because of the hash brown?
Yeah. What am I, pregnant?
DeRosa just sells sandwiches for pregnant ladies.
Yeah, like that's like some of the pregnant chick ones.
Sour cream and onion chips and haggis.
I mean, yeah, I'll never try that sandwich. It's repulsive. But
I want to go by and get one of his peanut butter and jellies.
Let me see the other Joe. Or can I put it up, dude? What you just put on the chat?
Oh, here, yeah. So this is the
Joey Roses.
There it is.
Wait, Joey Roses. By the way, they forgot an apostrophe.
So it's just.
Oh no, it's just Joey Roses. I see. Like Tom's River is not a river that belongs to Tom.
Got it. So you thought it was Joey Roses sandwiches.
He's not Joey Rose. And okay,
normally the fat kid looks great. Peanut butter, grape jelly, okay, ruffle, potato.
Joey,
chips.
The heart eight. I can't read all of the first two because our windows are blocking it. Like, so can you like lower it and scroll? You know what I mean?
Do you want me to read it to you?
Go down. Yeah, go. Yeah, read me the first two.
The first two is the Eastie.
Okay.
Which is prosciutto, salami, Asiago, pepperdews, olives, and I think that's it.
He should have called it the Eastville and named it after that. Who's the guy who used to own the Eastville?
Marco. He just
that's what he Marco.
Really, what he really should have done is done eight club owners, you know? Like
yeah.
He should have done like the Lucian, the Marco, what was the dude's fucking name from that used to own Stand Up New York?
Carrie Hoffman. He used to sing. You know, Carrie Hoffman used to sing Frank Sinatra songs.
Yeah,
and they called him Old Jew Eyes.
And he funded the first laser. Comes back. The second one's called the Rosie, which is mortadella.
This is making me very hungry, by the way. So it's mortadella.
Mortadella. Sorry, I don't say it like a real Ginzo.
No, white that's American. Italian. Mortadella is how you say it if you're like where I'm from.
Yeah, mortadella.
New Jersey. Yeah, it's not mortadella. That's like ignorant Italian Americans who talk like morons say it, but it's mortadella or something. It's like, you're not going to say it really.
I never thought I was going to go through this pronunciation game with you, though. This is.
But you're right to say mortadella because trying to say it properly Italian does sound dumber than just saying
mortadella. Yeah, it's like when my mom's at a restaurant and orders
mortadella, white American? Why does it have to be a white American? Tomato?
Caucasian American.
What's that say? Hot Cheetos?
Hot cherries.
Oh, not hot Cheetos, because it's cut off. I thought he put hot Cheetos on it.
Oh, that's more of an uptown sandwich.
The Ami, I guess that's short for salami, because it's a salami kind of sandwich.
Or Amish. Cooked.
Amish.
This thing was made with zero electricity. It's salami, provolone, parmesan.
He should make one called like the Joe DeRosa torso, and it's just like half of a game hen. A Cornish game in
on a
served open face
with a Pabst Blue Ribbon in his hand.
With a Pabst Blue Ribbon tucked in its wing.
Yeah, it's got hair sprinkled on the middle of it.
Wait, is it it's a Cornish game hen served open face with a fedora.
Yeah, he should have just gone. These names are too like middle of the road for no one. He should have done things that like people know Joe DeRosa for. Like he should have made a sandwich called like the Kumia.
I disagree.
Like, this is why.
I disagree because the name Joey Roses, I think it took me a little while to realize Joey Roses was Joe DeRosa. I've heard the name Joey Roses.
Oh, this is his Chris Gaines?
Yes. That's it. Yes. That's exactly what I was getting at.
This is his sandwich, Chris Gaines?
Can we put up a picture of Chris Gaines, please, Joey, so people understand the concept of Chris Gaines?
Chris Gaines.
I don't remember the country singer's name who plays Chris
Garth
Gaines.
Garth Brooks.
Okay, so Garth Brooks. Do you remember this, Joe, that the Garth Brooks, his rocker persona?
Wait, you asking?
Oh yeah, grab it. But yeah. Irish, did you ever? It just says Irish O'Neill, so instead of Joe.
Oh yeah, no.
You remember? It was the dark side of Chris. No,
it was the sad emo side.
So let's put a picture up of.
Let's come up with our own Chris Gaineses today.
Well, I was going to do Kurt Games, but I ended up doing Pussies with Kyle. But that my, you know, Kyle did another guy, and then I came in, and I was going to do that character alone. But it's just funnier on Pussies.
Yeah.
So here's Garth Brooks, and he always wanted to be a. Like the guy from the Goo Goo Dolls or something? I don't know what he's going for here, his look.
I think he just wanted to be a rock star.
They're like homos, right?
Yeah. They want to, you know, it's like when you find out that Bowie and Mick Jagger were in bed together. That's how it is when you find out that these country guys really just want to be baristas in Seattle. They're sick of singing about trucks and mud and jeans.
You want to see how the other side lives. And I wonder if I had fruity hair and a little Zorch.
Oh, man. I bet Garth Brooks has pulled out that guitar and just started singing Goo Goo Dolls and just wept.
Is there any other pictures of Chris Gaines? Is there any like...
There's like a performance of him.
Did he ever go out like Ollie?
He did SNL.
As Chris Gaines?
Yeah, dude. He fucking...
So he had to do a wig change before the...
Yeah, dude.
That's already doing wig... What? Can we see that, a live performance by Chris Gaines? See if you can find that.
I would love to watch it.
You're not going to watch a whole thing. I want to promise you that.
I don't think. I want to get through it like a comedy special. Hour challenge.
It's so great because it's like a, you know, John Mulaney had that joke about the mean trans hooker.
Yeah.
Is this your notion of a woman?
Yeah.
And I think this is like, is this your notion of a rock star? And Joe DeRosa, this is his notion of a sandwich guy. It's his take on being a sandwich guy.
This is like, you know, when older men get divorced and then they they get like super tan and move to Scottsdale and just get into fucking.
I'm not from Arizona, so no.
Yeah, well, that's a big thing. That's a big thing in Arizona. Yeah. You see a lot of guys that were like nice dads until they're 45 and then their wife left and then they're
Scottsdale
like,
is such a place for a guy who's middle-aged to wear Bono glasses.
Oh, Bono glasses and an Ed Hardy shirt. And just have shaved forearms.
Yeah, Scottsdale is. I say it's like if LA and Vegas had a slow baby.
Yeah, yeah, and just all these women are walking around with rock tits.
They're like, just like LA won't acknowledge it. It's LA's kid.
It's the shadow of LA is Scottsdale.
Yeah,
it's
just Vegas like, just raises alone and tells the things about LA.
Yeah, it's like don't worry, you don't look like LA, and then someone sees it, and it's like you look a lot like bad LA, and they're like, whoa, you said I didn't look like LA. Scottsdale is.
Wait, Joey said I'm having trouble finding live footage of Chris Gaines, but still looking.
Dude, I wonder if he had it pulled like Rob Delaney did of that set on Jimmy Kimmel.
If we can even hear audio of him.
I really think Garth, dude. We just found
a mystery.
Garth Brooks has enough money to have Chris Gaines wiped from the internet.
This is like Eddie and the Cruisers when Eddie disappeared.
Yeah, dude. They were like, Chris Gaines is gone. Chris who?
Wow, he finally put the Chris Gaines persona. You know what his Chris Gaines persona was like? It was like Spider-Man 3 when Tobey Maguire was the bad Spider-Man.
Yeah, when they did Venom poorly and he was like singing and dancing and like
yeah, evil. That's the dark side of him, as he goes to piano bars and dances all night.
Oh, dude, Chris Gaines just leans against the piano and just sings, I'd give up forever to touch you.
Can we have the footage? Okay, you put Tobey Maguire, Spider-Man 3 dance. Because there's a thing where he's doing like a Staying Alive. Like,
yeah, he like walks down the street.
It's to indicate that he's losing himself in the evil of becoming Venom.
Yes.
And that's what happens when you start to go to the dark side. You start swinging your pelvis.
Yeah, you start being
really musical. Yeah, that's what Chris Gaines did.
Wait, so you're saying that Garth Brooks had an exorcism and then had to have...
I'm saying there's some kind of venom.
Symbiote?
There's a symbiote.
And
I believe
yeah.
It attacked Tobey Maguire. Then, Brooks first, then Tobey Maguire, and now it's turning Joey DeRosa into a sandwich man.
Joe DeRosa's sandwich venom.
Okay, yeah. Let's see. This is short, right? Let's just take a look at this.
This is really awful. This is Joe DeRosa walking to the stand to make sandwiches.
This is like when Pete Holmes got a TV show. How are you liking? Hey, come on, Pete Holmes, cut it out.
Oh, hey.
Your shots are so good.
I'd love to shoot you sometime.
He's got Chris Gaines' hair.
Yeah. Is that the sign? Are those the devil horns?
Wait, but go back to that, him hitting on the girl. Wait. So when he got bangs.
Dude, if you get bangs, you go full Chris Gaines.
He's got almost the same hair as this girl.
Does Joe DeRosa have bangs currently? I haven't seen him in a long
time. He gets bangs, he better never. If Jay gets bangs, I'll never speak to him again.
Then we need to do Garth Brooks exorcism. We need to play Big country. Jay,
you found some gifts of Gaines? All right, we'll look at some Gaines gifts.
Gaines gifts.
Because we're piecing together a conspiracy here. We really are. With Joey Roses and this Chris Gaines thing.
Yeah,
he's going to blow this wide open.
We're going to find out that something. Oh, man. Look at that.
He must have scrubbed it. Chris Gaines, Way of the song is called Way of the Girl.
That's written by like a robot that thinks he's a human.
I mean, it sounds like he's following what he thinks is the way of the girl. Scroll the thread. Let's see.
Dude, I'm looking up Chris Gaines on Bing.
The one shot where Garth sort of seeps through. Oh, that's cool.
Damn, dude.
Wow, better detectives. Oh, look at that kick.
Oh. That's a Steven Seagal kick.
He kicks like a lady. That's the way of the girl. All right, go up a little more. This is amazing.
Garth's secret identity.
Oh, here we go. Dude had swagger even when he was just hanging out. How come this doesn't have more retweets?
I don't know. How come Chris Gaines?
The greatest gif. Yes. Oh, Jay would love this. That
dude, we need to find.
Wow. If Joey Roses is half as good a sandwich man as Chris Gaines is, Way of the Girl? Rocker?
I found music of his. There's a thing called Chris Gaines Interview Part 1. It's on Vimeo.
Oh, okay. Find that. Chris Gaines Interview Part 1.
But it's just his music. It's like Garth Brooks being interviewed, but it is. Oh, dude, there is some Chris Gaines.
Okay, wait. Joey, do you hear that? Get that.
It's called Chris Gaines Interview Part 1 on Vimeo.
I wish so bad I had this. I had a Joey Roses sandwich right now to watch.
Oh, a fat boy? If you're just eating hash browns and peanut butter?
What's it called? The fat bitch? All right.
Press yeah.
In the life of Chris Gaines will be right back on NBC.
What? So he's doing 30. He's
probably
like
the most asked question that I get about Chris Gaines is, what's it like to play two different people?
Press pause.
And the answer
It's called bipolar.
Okay. Number one, that is not the question that you get asked the most about Chris Gaines. If that is the question you were asked the most about Chris Gaines, you don't have a single person who loves you in your fucking life.
If
the question was, number one, why are you doing this? Everyone who loves you should have said that to you.
Make eye contact with Garth Brooks after seeing him as Chris Gaines, that's the number one question.
This is like Elvis at the end.
Yeah, where Elvis was like, no, everyone loves that I'm doing pills. We love it, King. We love it. We love it.
The best King. All right, press
oh, play. You know what? That's another, that ties into our conspiracy theory. Hold on. Because Elvis loved peanut butter and banana sandwiches, which is a very pregnant lady sandwich.
Maybe Joe DeRosa is pregnant.
Joe DeRosa is
Oh,
Elvis.
My God. Okay, press play.
People, I'm playing one. The Garth Brooks thing is just who I am. The Chris Gaines thing, though, the closer you look and the more you find out, you realize Chris Gaines is Garth Brooks. So all it is.
Oh, please wait. Please rewind a little bit.
Of course.
Go back just a little.
What kind of hayseed idiots does he think he's singing country to?
Dude, Chris, Garth Brooks, there's a whole thing special. This might be the Garth Brooks special. The Garth Brooks special, he comes off like such a fucking Nimrod. All right.
Jesus.
And I'm sorry to use a word like that. All right, press play.
That's
Chris
the new
Gaines
retard.
Thing, though, the closer you look and the more
No, go back to where he goes, what I get asked the most. He lives in a completely, there's all these like where he keeps like crying partway, not in this, in his, the real Garth Brooks. He goes, he's full of shit. He's like a fat girl that's into theater. All right, press play.
Probably the most asked question that I get about Chris Gaines is, what's it like to play two different people? And the answer is, first, let's get one thing straight. I'm not playing two different people. I'm playing one. The Garth Brooks thing is just who I am. The Chris Gaines thing, though, the closer you look and the more you find out, you realize Chris Gaines is Garth Brooks. So
number two question I get
is
the number two question I get is the wig itchy. And that answer... Yes, is yes, it is an itchy wig. When you don't think that bang wigs are going to itch. But
my favorite part, he goes, people ask this question that no, they don't ask him. And he goes, let's get some straight right here.
Yeah. Stops. I'm here to address the rumors.
Okay, I'm here to set the record straight about Chris Gaines.
I don't care what Brendan Schaub says. I do not have a Chinese accent.
We are not two different people. We are the same man playing two different people.
Dude, so the fact that
get that straight first.
The fact that he has fucking football coach head and then puts on and then puts on a sad Katie Lang wig. And then just does things where he does that little kick.
He puts on his Tobey Maguire Spider-Man 3 wig.
Yeah, he puts on his Venom wig.
Do people know, is that the original wig from Spider-Man 3 that Tobey Maguire wore?
And then he marches to town to make a Joe DeRosa sandwich.
He should make sandwiches, and Joey DeRosa should do the queef rock. All right, press play.
I would love to. I'll tell you what, if a guy that looks like Garth Brooks is making me a sandwich, and it's got some sort of smoked meats, I trust it.
What if it's hash browns and peanut butter and jelly?
I believe it. Looking at this guy, he looks like he eats hash browns regularly.
Oh, yeah. That should have been the name of his rock alter ego. They call me Hash Brown. Oh, yeah.
All it is taking Garth Brooks and Chris Gaines and
putting and fucking
them together the same way we took a song from the 60s and the 90s and put them together.
What? The way I blow my
because so here's what happens. Garth Brooks gets down on his knees and he sucks Chris Gaines' dick.
Garth Brooks gets down on one knee and says, Chris Gaines, will you be my lawfully wedded partner to make this album?
And then you know what Chris Gaines does? Chris Gaines lays back on a bed of flowers, and then Garth Brooks gets on top. And a lot of people don't know this, but homosexuals can have missionary sex. And that's when...
But he doesn't... He must suck his own dick like an Ouroboros.
Yeah, he's the never-ending
snake. Eating itself?
Yeah.
It should be a snake sucking its own dick. That would represent him.
Dude, what if he had that, like, the red dragon tattoo on his back? And he's like, that's who I am.
He should
that's
have a tattoo of himself eternally blowing himself.
Dude, Garth blowing Garth? Please, someone create that. Like,
they play this. Well, let's see the rest of the interview.
Like an old hieroglyphic.
I had no idea how much interest I would have in this, but I'm fascinated.
It's probably the crossroads where Garth and Chris meet dead on, and probably the most they're alike. And a song called "Right Now."
Ew. Wait, this is what he did? Man, pause it.
Here he is answering the question he gets asked the most.
Is what's up? Are you drinking again?
Are you drinking again?
Yeah, this is crazy. This is the action of a man where you're like, hey, are you? This is a midlife crisis. This had to have been a midlife crisis.
This was a long time ago. He did this. I wasn't a comedian when he started doing this.
It's like the '90s. I think he did it in the '90s. Garth Brooks was so big, no one stopped him from doing this.
It's the same as when Joe DeRosa got a fucking tattoo at age 38,
or opened a sandwich shop. We let him go, Chris Gaines.
Joe DeRosa has had the longest midlife crisis I've ever.
But Jay went and bought all the sandwiches, and he said they were very good. And I trust DeRosa making sandwiches more than I trust...
Jay just likes sandwiches. No, they're probably good. Listen, the Stand has excellent food.
Yes.
That club, their food was like... I didn't know how they could stay in business because their food was good.
Yeah, it's like, remember Comics, how good their food was? And then they were like, a year later, they're like, we don't have food anymore.
Yeah, that's right.
That cost too much. That was way too much.
We're not putting truffle oil on every goddamn thing.
Dude, when Comics came out, they were like, yeah, you do a set, you get $75, and then we waterboard you with truffle oil. And then you have a four-course
prefix meal.
And then you get everyone gets a fifth of Crown Royal and the bag when they leave.
They pitch out in pirate rations of rum. Press play.
Would you like rubies and then a barrel of rum?
So his whole thing.
Oh, yeah, dude. Get ready, everyone. I'm about to hit a Chris Gaines phase in my mid-40s.
This is great that he thinks this is what... That's what this guy played.
Go back. Can you go back 2 seconds just when he's standing in the hotel hallway? So watch it. When he's standing here, they're definitely either had to rent out the entire hallway right here, or someone came out of the room and was like, sorry. And you're like, oh, was that Garth Brooks?
The door, they're like, is that I'm sure they rented the whole floor. It wasn't people stepping into the shot. His Chris Gaines glamour shots.
He goes, sorry, I'm going to do bird is the word, but sad.
That's the thing. He looks like an emo guy. He should be singing Depeche Mode or something.
Yeah, and he's
but
doing
he's singing 60s fucking
yeah
music from commercials.
He goes, I'm going to do a little Buffalo Springfield sad.
I do mostly Ben and Jerry rock from the 60s.
I was going to do some Mamas and some Papas with a little stank on it.
Come on, people now.
I hate it.
It sounds like church music. It sounds like the rock songs that are okay to play in church.
This is what happens when...
And by the way, Christians look like this now in cool churches. They all look like Chris Gaines.
Yeah, the pastors do. Where
this
they're
is
going
the
like,
of a cool pastor. That's
yeah. Dude, I bet cool pastors love Chris Gaines.
Let them cut loose a little bit. They want to listen to like the bad boy music, like, come on, people now, try to love one another.
They go, that is some pretty dark stuff. But if Chris Gaines is soothing it,
singing
I thought
it, there was backwards messages in that song. Until the bad boy, Chris Gaines.
Man, if I really just give up on comedy, if there's another pandemic and I just want to go cool pastor, that's all you got to do is just have a soul patch, long hair, and do stuff.
I'm thinking I'd like to become a cool pastor, but I'm going to have to get a wig because I don't have bangs.
You have to get a long wig, and then you're going to have to do stuff like, when I'm on the gram checking out some other cool stuff, and they're like,
Grant, Instagram.
Yeah, dude. You gotta
I run an Instagram ministry.
Dude, that's the money. There's the money.
Instagram.
Can I be one of your, can I be like the behind
the scenes
guy?
It's called Gospel on the Gram.
Dude, Gospel Gram?
Yeah, Gospel Gram. That's my
God Gram?
Gospel Gram is my Instagram ministry.
I'm warning you that I'm going to break off in a couple of years and form my own sect called God Graham.
That's great. We need to get the word out.
Sure, we'll be moving the message, but then it will become a bitter rivalry. I'm just letting you know.
Yeah, well.
You will basically become the Protestants to my Catholics.
I think God will decide who the true servant is.
We'll see
who God
follows.
Like Justin Bieber's cool pastor and show dick neck when I go to the beach.
You're gonna show fucking. That's unfair.
You see that picture?
Yeah, because that's unfair. Because you and gray sweatpants, you're just gonna be knocking around, and everyone's gonna be following your word.
Put in Justin Bieber in pastor. I saw this Rogan show to me a long time ago.
Well, it was just Bieber's pastor showing dong.
Or maybe I saw it in a clip of Rogan. Maybe he didn't show it to me. I might be just confusing a time I saw.
I do that with pro wrestling all the time. Like when Sting and I won the tag.
Rogan told me to take vitamins.
Yeah, I remember one time Virgil just stopped putting up with my shit. And you're like, wait, do you think you're $1 million man, Ted DiBiase? Am I not? That's not who
Virgil chopped me in the chest. It was actually kind of awesome. It was like a wrestling. It was like very loud and like shocked me how loud it was, but it didn't hurt.
Yeah, did he roast the hand slap?
We're doing the roast of like the third roast of the Iron Sheik.
Yeah, I did the second one, I think.
Yeah, he really needed new knees, that poor fucker. And there's all these old broken down wrestlers where I'm like, oh, this is just horrible what happens to these guys.
It's like doing a Friars Club roast.
Yeah, I made a joke about how somebody used to Virgil for someone else.
Yeah.
Like, I don't remember what the joke was, but something like that. He used to Virgil for something. It was insulting. But yeah. Virgil came up and went whack and chopped me. It was awesome,
yeah.
Though.
Yeah, because you're like, oh, shit. Am I hurt? And then
it was
like,
a fake wrestling move that was very loud but didn't hurt, but it looked like he wrestling chopped me, and it was like a cool, like one time Roddy Piper threatened to hit me with a chair, which I wish he did.
I remember that story. Jay told me that story.
Yeah, because I said he wanted to come up and he was at the show and he wanted us to bring him on stage, but like he was going to refuse to come on, and we like, come on, and he goes, oh, okay, and then come on.
Yeah, so he wanted you to do the, no, then, everyone dude, wants to hear
again,
you.
Again, guy, who doesn't love Rowdy Roddy Piper, the star?
I mean,
best. They're all like going to do stand up. And you know, like, and that's the thing. Like, I would not watch Brendan Schaub critically because I was like, I wasn't looking at him as like, he's like a friend of somebody that I know. And like, so I wouldn't even have harsh words to say about it, especially because I'm like, well, he's some jock that got.
Yeah.
Like, I don't mean that in a bad way. I'm just like, I wouldn't even, it'd be mean to like pick his hour apart to me.
Yeah. Because you're saying it's not on the same ground as someone that like started.
Because I wasn't, and I don't mean that in any kind of way of like, as I'm saying, it seems like I'm not being mean, right? I'm just like, I wasn't judging him the way I would judge a comic.
Yeah, so I think there's.
You know what I mean? Like, I've seen people, like the thing I told you I saw where it was somebody who was like mad that he had an hour.
Yeah.
Just somebody on you. And I'm like, it wouldn't occur to me to be mad that he did an hour. If you got a following that will watch you, that's why you get an hour.
You're just the way that Gronkowski got the hour on.
Yeah. If it's not a good hour, you'll probably be embarrassed looking back.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
If there's an hour of you, of your, one of your first sets.
I found an old DVD of like my first, one of my first weekends working in Tucson. And I, it's like, it makes me nauseous to watch. So to
my old one, Jay has, I haven't watched it, but I think he found a VCR and played it, one of our old original.
Oh yeah, you guys have the tape from the Laugh House.
And the jokes aren't bad. Like, it's not that my jokes are bad. They're kind of like better than me. You know, like yeah. And my delivery is so nervous. And if they like, I'm like, oh geez, like I'm doing like an aw shucks.
Yeah.
My face, I'm not saying, but my face is like, like it's so just hilarious.
That, just that noise. I'm like,
Yeah. So I'm saying the jokes way too fast.
Yeah.
We used to call it the Kurt face. He goes, don't make the Kurt face when you go on stage.
I'm doing a flat out copy of Chappelle.
What, you hit your leg with a mic?
I think there's is a knee slap. I think there's a knee slap.
You actually give yourself a microphone knee slap. Now, I thought dropping the mic, you're a piece of shit. But yeah. You're doing a Dane Chappelle microphone knee slap.
Kurt, I'm coming clean right now, all right? I'm not saying it was a good
move. I know it was hard for you, but I really want to attack you.
It was hard for you to admit that. But yeah, it was 2004. The knee slap hadn't hit the hack market as
hot. I wish to God you'd revealed instead to me that you harbor secret sandwich dreams.
What if respect. I told you that sandwiches are for chumps? I'm in the soup game now, Kurt. I got Dan Soder's toilet soup. I'm gonna make soup.
Danny Soder's toilet soup.
Yeah, Danny's fucking tub soup. I'm gonna make bathtub soup.
Wait, what's your cool instead of Soder? What's your cool Rose's name?
What's my Chris Gaines name?
Yeah, what's your Chris Gaines name?
I'd probably Donald Soups. Donald Soup. I'm just gonna make tub soup and be Donald Soups.
I want to see an ad of Dan Soder and you're doing your Donald Soup character.
Dude, come get the soups. Come drink the soups, and it's gonna be.
You gotta take a picture of you. Like, it's me, Donald Soup.
I'm gonna be, and dude, get ready, because in the winter months, there's gonna be a bisque that's gonna knock your socks off.
I'm gonna be known as Donald Soup.
Yeah, dude, Donald Soup. Donald Soup and the Bisque Boys. don't fuck with my crew. We're gonna get big, dude. We're getting big.
What's up? This is Donald Soup. I'm coming at you with the new soups.
What's up? It's your boy, Donnie Soups.
We got a squash and lobster bisque. You like bisque? Now it's got squash.
Donald Soup. Don't forget about our October split pea. We're going to be splitting fire.
Or harvest pee. You give it all those fucking jerk off artisanal names.
Oh, man. We've got a nice. Yeah, dude. We can do.
Why not relax with a cool glass jar of cold soup?
Yeah. We would love for you to try some of our bisque and also some of our fall corn chowder.
Donald Soup. Please.
Donald Soups, dude. Donnie Soups.
Oh, it's Donald Soups, plural.
Yeah,
and not no, no apostrophe.
Yeah, here's like my question, because we're spitballing here. Yeah. Since it's Joey Roses, do I go by Donnie Soups or do I go full Donald?
Donald Soups.
Man, Donald Soups. Donald Soups does sound better.
How do you spell soups? Like soup?
Yeah, you just spell it S-O-U-P-S. You know, just right down the line.
Donald Soups.
Donald Soups.
Donald Soups, bad time bisque, or like
Oh, I gotta have names for it. I gotta call
bad boy of bisque is back,
dude. Rock my Rocky Mountain chowder.
my Rocky Mountain chowder. Hey, dude, I'm Donald Soups.
What about my fucking Bay Area bisque?
Dude, you should be that guy who's like, that's how if you're a guy with a dream, like that guy who sells soap.
Yeah,
and he's like, the soap you're using is shit. Why don't you use this soap?
Yeah, why don't you guys stop sucking that pond water?
It's like, wow, dude, you seem soups. Like a good guy that really cares about soap. Like, that's how he comes off.
It's yeah. Like,
there's got to be a better soup. Donald dude. Soups.
But then, you know, to go along with everything we're talking about, I'm not a soups guy. So I hope these other soups guys, these like lifelong soup guys, they can't judge me. They can't watch.
What's my fucking first Chris Gaines side hustle? I guess.
Oh, dude. I would say.
I guess comedy.
Or baked goods. Why don't you start baking stuff, dude? Or a butcher.
No, I wouldn't be good at that. My name means butcher. Metzger means butcher in German.
All right. All right. We're getting there closer. Well, sandwiches, Joey Rose's got it. I've got the soup game locked down.
Donald Soups. You're like coming in hard on the soups. Maybe I'll do my Gospel Graham Instagram ministry. That's where my calling is in the ministry.
You're right. And I would actually probably need to come to you for several fiscal favors. I need to be backed by the...
You could probably work a deal to serve Donald Soups at a lot of our events.
At your soup kitchens that you do? Come on. Yeah.
But what is it like? Donald Soup's like something kitchen. Like
Donald Soup's God kitchen. Donnie Soup's is...
No, not my thing. I mean for you. Like it's like, you know, they say like bad lemonade or what's that fucking drink? It's not called bad lemonade.
Oh,
it's
dirty water or something? Bad water? What is it?
Yeah, like down and dirty fucking soup.
Yeah, dude. Well, I'll have my jizz soup. I'll have...
what did you call it? Your Rocky Mountain clam chowder?
Dude, my Rocky Mountain chowder. It's not even clams, it's buffalo balls. It's buffalo balls.
You got to try my new Rocky Mountain. You're like a new Sam Adams of our time with soups. Yeah. Soups.
Dude, Donald Soups is hitting them from the side. I'm going to give you everything. I'm going to give you our pineapple chicken noodle. Dude,
can I tell you? I know somebody, because this is such a solid idea. Somebody listening will produce a Donald Soups promo material.
I'm excited for it.
And I'm excited to see, because it's such a solid thing. And you could.
That's what happens. You put it out in the internet, and then you let the internet come back to you with beautiful gifts.
You could be a soup influencer.
Ah, dude, I've always wanted to be a soup influencer. And then I might have my signature cool blow, you know, and I'm blowing on a thing of soup. I go like. and then I take the spoon of soup. Fucking down the hatch, baby. The soup shit's about to change my life, dude. It's about to change my fucking life.
Oh, dude. You want to hear something hilarious that Kyle told me a sketch that I still want to do, but we keep forgetting? But this is his idea. I thought it was so fucking funny. He wanted to have a fake one-man show called A Mile in Their Shoes.
That's great.
He steps into a different pair of shoes and does the character.
Dude, that is...
He gets into another pair of shoes. I was like, one actor, 12 shoes, dude, one unforgettable show.
Directed by Neil Brennan. Dude. 12 shoes, a dozen feet. What is it called? Two dozen feet.
No, it's like, wait. Six characters, 12 shoes. I have the numbers down. It's called A Mile in Their Shoes.
Have you ever talked to Rachel Feinstein about her one woman show ideas?
She really is a one woman show.
She has some of the fucking greatest fake one woman show title names. She would tell me while we were waiting to go up at like East Willow New York Comedy Club. One of them was like All the Way to Rape and Back Again. Big Apple. Oh man, you gotta get her. Yeah, you gotta ask her. She has like 20 of these one woman show names that are all fucking really funny.
Yeah, that's fucking beautiful, dude. I mean, yeah, no Donald Soups, but Donald
Soups. Well, dude, Donald Soups is about to change our lives with your ministry backing it, and I'm gonna snuff out Joey Rose's.
Can I show you an athlete to promote Donald Soups?
Yes.
Okay, so Irish, do you have, because I don't want to confuse with Joey Rose's, Irish O'Neill, my engineer.
Yeah, Irish O'Neill does soaps. Irish O'Neill does the soaps.
So somebody sent the Texas to me laughing about it, okay? And as far as I can tell, it's a real thing. But play that video of the outstanding athlete. I think this is for Donald Soups, if you want to be a hip. This will be your spokesman.
You're on the board, dude. You're on the board of soups.
Okay, as someone who serves on the board of Donald Soups,
yeah.
I think this athlete is our, it's hip, it's now. It's everything that we want to associate with soup.
Yeah, I'm guessing it's not the lady with the birthmark on her face.
Ew, no. Oh, my God. No.
I know a lot of beautiful women with Drew Breeses.
Oh, my God. I didn't even know she had that. Well, now I'm going. Do
you think she was turning into a tree?
So this is CeCe Telfer, who's just won Outstanding Trans Athlete not too long ago.
Okay.
In women's track. And where do you see how it's standing?
I think Leah and Danielle are about to get fucking smoked.
Yeah, I think birthmark face is going to get left behind, just like in life.
I'm just a regular girl living my best life, you know.
Why isn't it playing? Oh.
Here it is. Bam. And oh, bye. Bye. Damn.
I'm being bashed by the media. I'm being bashed by all the conservatives.
I want to watch Birthmark.
I guess you give can say. Up. And I honestly.
Dude, wait, if you're in lane two, you're like, come
wait, on. Wait, listen to CC because I want you to understand
that's
why
the scientific definition that.
Wait, go back, Joey, because we missed it.
By the media, I'm being bashed by all the conservatives, I guess you can say. And I honestly don't even consider myself as trans. I just consider myself as a female. And
fair enough.
It's unfair because that's the scientific definition that describes what or who I am is a trans female, but internally in myself I know that I'm a female.
Damn.
Okay, press pause.
Jeez.
That's your entire right there. That's your first Donald Soups commercial.
Yeah, dude. Donald Soups
comes up.
Yeah, dude. You know what we'll do is when she fucking beats everyone in the race, she crosses the finish line and we got a cup of Rocky Mountain chowder for her. And she takes a bite of the buffalo ball.
And splashes it on that fucking birthmark face.
When she bites into the oyster and it pops on the fucking, on Drew Brees' face.
On that fucking disgusting, not as good of an athlete
spit
woman.
Spit on my microphone. That's how excited
that's the commercial. And we see CC Telfer go, I don't like this. And just throw this peg, that other chick in the head with it.
Yeah, and they go.
And it goes, yeah.
Donald Soups. It's not to be thrown.
This ain't throwing soup.
This ain't your mom's throwing soup. Yeah, dude, this is a $1 million idea.
Is it a great ad for Donald Soups?
I mean,
play the rest of that because I think there's other shit on there that was making
print it.
Like the rest of it, there's something about dating
straight
where I'm like
female, so a transgender female who is heterosexual who likes heterosexual men. I'm very feminine and I don't like to, I don't like my muscles. So like things like that. Like I don't like to be like seen as like strong or like jacked. Like if somebody calls me jacked, like I feel some type of way because I'm like, no, I'm a female. I'm not supposed to be jacked. But everybody in the gym, everybody
it's funny
in the
when,
area was
like everyone in the
staring
gym.
At me like
when you,
they've never
it's
seen
it's funny when you, hear meathead lingo that's like in this context where it's like technically she's a jock, so she's gonna use like jock vernacular. So she's like, I don't like hearing when people are like, "Whoa, bro, you're repping crazy weight." It's all like,
but that's the thing you would say to a woman. Like I call, I say everyone, I say dude to women or man. I go, "Hey, man," to women, and I did that for years.
Hey guys,
because it's egalitarian, so it is a thing. Like, because I know someone could take it like I'm calling them a man, but I'm not. Like I call women man. You're getting woman. But anyway, it hasn't come up yet in my life, but. Right here, see what she's holding? The outstanding.
Yeah.
That's where you put like her holding a Donald soup.
Oh yeah.
Maybe like a bowl of Donald soups.
Just a bowl of like our pineapple chicken noodle or our
CC
Bay
Telfer.
Area breeze. Yeah.
Yeah, CC Telfer, the spokeswoman of Donald soups. Fucking outstanding. An outstanding soup for an outstanding athlete. This is literally
man.
The best woman. This
her choice. I would personally recommend the Minnesota chili. That's probably what I would have, is that northern chili.
The Minnesota chili.
Yeah, it's cold chili.
Oh, that's refreshing.
It is. It's heavy on bean and meat. And
kick back on a hot summer day with a cold Minnesota chili.
Yep, and it comes in a waffle cone. So
whoa.
Oh man, Donald Soups is going off. We're coming for chili roses. We gotta get crazy.
Whoa. I think we have a huge marketable thing here with CC Telfer.
And I'm gonna tell you right now, Kurt, I'm opening up the market for a throw-in soup. I think we should make a throw-in soup.
This ain't your mama's throw-in soup.
And it's called Mama's Throw-in Soup. it's just a bag of broth and a fucking water It's just a water balloon. Instead of soup dumplings, it's just water balloons filled with chicken, hot chicken stock.
It's a water balloon filled with hot chicken stock. That you,
it's an old
mama's old-fashioned throwing soup.
I get four mama's throwing soups and a Rocky Mountain chowder and Minnesota chili.
Is there any other flavors we can expect from Donald Soups?
Oh, dude, we have so much. We're going to actually have one called the San Antonio Trans, which is a potato soup that's actually lentil. So we're gonna get real.
It's lentil, and you like, I'm pretty sure this tastes like potato. And you're like, please, you're fired from work.
Yeah, you're fired. That's offensive. Offensive.
You've just put lentil in mortal danger.
You're out of here,
sir. Speaking of mortal danger.
Yeah.
But this, I don't want to discourage you from getting this person as a spokesman, but you see AOC's fucking horseshit sob story about how she thought, I literally was murdered.
I thought I was going to die.
I didn't follow all the news of that, you know? Like,
yeah.
When the end of Animal House happened in Washington, D.C.
Yeah, dude. I mean, well, I was...
when they totally ruined that parade for the fucking... And the guy was dressed like John Belushi as a fucking pirate or whatever.
Dude, it's just so funny watching all those people just go full fucking like happy hour drunk fun to the Capitol. And then there was like a bunch of them that were like, there's a couple of them that are like, we can like do some fucking,
well, dude,
break some stuff.
The thing is that she was saying, this was funny with the stuff that, so I didn't pay super close attention, but basically what I noticed is like, she said to that guy, that fish man, Senator Ted Cruz, you almost had me killed, which is like, yeah. I'd be like, bitch, if I had you killed, you'd be dead, first of all.
That is,
but secondly, yeah,
that's the version of her going,
so stop. I was like, so can you stop actually
yelling? You're yelling at me right now, can you stop yelling at me?
It is being, it's
her going, and, like, you're being crazy right now, you're literally being crazy.
So wait, so that's how I first heard about it. And then the story I heard is like, okay, so I didn't know what all happened there. Like, I'm like, oh, maybe people stormed in the building she was in.
Yeah,
because you heard her tell her story, right?
I haven't heard it, no.
Her fucking story is, I was in there and then I heard, where is she? Where is she? She heard people shouting and she hid and she ran to another center. She's like, I have to hide. I don't know if I'll ever be a mother, all this shit. It wasn't anybody storming the building. It was a cop coming to evacuate them. By the way,
really? That's what happened?
Because of a pipe bomb threat from earlier. So she was well out of the way. See, this is, they're trying to like, they don't want another Jesse Smollett. The fucking regular media that jumped on board with this, because it's embarrassing. Yeah. But this moron gave what time she was about one. She said what time it was when this happened. So she's so stupid to do that, because if you say the time this supposedly happened, her story is a story that you could say is just her feelings. You can't.
AOC, what are you doing? That's like, you don't give a first name and an answer.
Listen, she's
on
not
Jeopardy. You just give the last name.
But this is how dumb this is. Her story was, her story was always that I was afraid something might happen to me. That's basically all the story was. Even the details are like, roll your eyes. It was still believable. But now, because of the time frame that it happened, it definitely was not that. She was already well out of the way. So she just made that up about how she felt.
Yeah. She's
That's
like,
mind-blowing.
You got to understand what happened on that day was.
And then she goes, I was sexually assaulted, which I got to say, I don't believe you.
You got to listen to the full story, because I heard that she came back from Vietnam and she was just walking through town to get a sandwich, and a sheriff stopped her and said, why don't I give you a lift out of town?
And
she
said, with a hose.
They spread her with a hose, and they looked at her scars and they said, oh my God. And then and then I was Rambo, and then I Ramboed,
and then the redheaded guy from NYT, NYPD. David Caruso washed my butt with a hose.
He gave me a hose wash. And then I killed
him. Ran into the woods.
Yeah, and then I ate a boar. And then I almost died. And then I turned the town upside down. Anyways, that was my day.
You have the clip? Okay, play the clip.
I just killed three of them. She's completely lying. I just took three out with my own hands.
Folks who tell us to move on, that it's not a big deal, that we should forget what's happened, or even telling us to apologize.
All right, press pause. Press pause. This is like, hey, guess what, bitch? How do you think it feels for people that all don't have health care, that you promised you were going to force a vote for Medicare for all? Now's the time to do it during a fucking pandemic, when we should have that, and you were going to knock down the house, and you were like, you need to make people uncomfortable. That's what government's about, making. And you didn't do none of that shit. You're just like a fucking, she literally does nothing. She's just a face.
With this picture up, it just looks like you're talking about your ex-girlfriend that you're still heated about.
I know, she is hot.
She didn't fucking say, she didn't do any of this. She didn't do any of this,
dude,
okay?
You know
she
what? That's you? You're right. That it's like the appeal of her. It's like America's fucking ex-girlfriend. Like,
That's why some people hate her and some people love her, where they're like, I'm gonna get her back.
Yeah, like, yeah, that's right. You're fucking right, dude. Because here's what dawned on me when her, I don't want to hear a rest of her stupid thing. I don't know, look it up. I don't want to hear her fucking emotional thing.
I don't want to see her. I'm still friends with her brother.
I cut her out of my life.
I
see her brother.
Yeah, that's
dude, that's
an
exact emotional reaction. Yeah. Because everything now is to get you emotionally to react to these people on a personal level.
Yeah.
And not worry about what they, so when somebody goes, well, who do you want to be president? Or who do you like? Somebody said to me, well, who do you like if you don't like? I'm like, who gives a shit who I like?
Yeah.
What are we going to hang out?
Yeah. Well,
that's remember that stupid, who do you want to have a beer with? Whenever that came out.
That was George W. Because they were like,
that's
don't
right.
you want to have a beer with him? He's like, yeah, it's not so much him I'm concerned about. It's this creepy vice president that seems to be eyeing up the middle.
And by the way, let's say we have a beer. What does that affect anything?
Yeah.
Let's say I hate your guts and I think you're a creep, but you just did a thing I want, like push the vote for Medicare for all.
Let's
say you just did that, like you said you were going to do.
Yeah,
that would be fine. I would, and I'll respect you. I'll go, I don't even like this motherfucker, but he says he's going to do this, and he did it.
Yeah.
So that's what this is. You're supposed to emotionally react to them. That's what this whole emotional trauma fucking. This is like how they program millennials now.
Dude, it's crazy, man. Because you went through some crazy shit as a kid. It's crazy when you go through...
it was nothing compared to what AOC went through.
But when you go through like heavy shit and then you're like told it's heavy, but you never looked at it like that, you're like...
Dude, let me tell you something. I was just talking to somebody, a friend of mine. Because,
yeah.
You know, in the comedy business, you know a lot of people that foul shit happened to them.
Dude, every comic, what's funny is when they get to theirs, you're always like, okay, that's why you're funny. Like when you find out that moment where you go,
and
like,
somebody who's really, by the way, yeah. Like this is why I don't believe her thing. I was sexual. That's why I think if she told the story of it, you'd be like, you weren't assaulted. That's what I suspect very deeply, because people I know that something real happened to, they don't cry like a bitch about a fake thing that didn't even happen to them because they thought, what if something could happen? They don't do that at all. In fact, it does something to them where, I don't know, they have perspective on what's real danger and what's just, you know.
Last time I was on this podcast, it was I was telling Bobby Hutch before
that
we started.
That guy, yeah. The guy who was on.
You had a full-on BBC war reporter in me.
That dude saw people blow up next to him.
That's what I'm saying. He was like, I didn't even realize I had PTSD until I was in therapy. Remember? That he was like,
dude, I don't believe it. That's why it seems phony. It seems like Jesse Smollett. It seems exactly like that.
Where he was just like, I don't know. And then a doctor told me that I should be dealing with all this. And then it fucked me up. And you're like,
imagine how much harder it is, though, Dan. That is easy to say because he's a male. Imagine you're a pretty girl that went to Harvard, how hard that is for you to deal with
tough.
The thought of anything, to have to face the idea that things happen.
Yeah, man. It's always like when you talk to like an old stripper, they always have this like kind of like attitude, like an old wrestler, where they're like, hell, brother, it happened. I'm still alive. I can put my shoes on my feet.
Yeah, I don't fucking respect that. I'm like, you're milking this. It's very obvious. But now, that was when I believed her trauma was real. When I believed it, I was like, you're milking this bit. All right, you know, it's time to stop being a millennial now.
Yeah.
But no. It was not that. She's faking that shit. It's all fucking fake.
Like a moon landing.
Just like the fucking moon landing, just like the supposed globe Earth.
I'm sick of all of it, dude. Donald Soups is going to take its money and it's going to invest its money with the right political candidates that can answer all these questions.
Yeah, I just want answers, okay? I don't know what shape the Earth is. I don't know. I just know I don't trust AOC. I don't trust the scientists.
Man, being a flat earther probably has like three strikes in your regular life where you just have to give it up. Where you're like,
we had a theory.
You work, your family, and then like an old friend that's like, come on, dude.
Dude, I was laughing with Neil Brennan about it because when I saw the fucking, you know, again, I always liked Owen, always liked him, but he's now a moon denier. I would not like him.
I mean, I would not. That's just a funny thing to be when you can see it. It's just like
he's like he'll lash out at you. Like apparently he did with me online. I didn't know because I wasn't online like that.
Yeah.
But last time I saw him, we got along great or whatever. And then like he's got like the worst followers, and I think they stoke him up. But anyway, but whatever. I wish him well. Like I hope he's okay. Fucking he's a moon. When I saw Moon Denier, I was like
the best.
The literal thing called the moon. That's what he's denying.
So then you can see at night.
No, Neil goes, what if you like hurt his feelings? He's going to stop believing in the sky. Like you say one more fucking thing and I'm going to stop believing in more stuff.
I'm going to be an air denier. I'm just going to hold my breath.
You're
an
air.
You don't need air. That's actually a government conspiracy.
I think here's the conspiracy. I do believe. I think they like, when by they I mean like establishment sources of news and whatever that are all. They enjoy crazy. They really like crazy. And if you're not crazy, that's why that chick who just said the thing that was crazy.
MTG.
Right? Yeah, it's crazy to say the power company made a forest fire laser.
Yeah, that's by crazy. Itself,
and Jerry Brown, the former governor, that's crazy.
She also had to.
But they added Jew lasers. They had to add that to it because it wasn't like, ooh, this isn't juicy enough of a crazy. Yeah. They like it to be extreme. And now that there's no Trump,
the
all
fact
their ratings
that,
are down. Yeah, all of them are down.
That's a very good point. And I was wondering how we were going to see the media react to Trump withdrawals, but Jew lasers seems to be their first move into being.
Well,
like,
not just that. It's gonna they're gonna grip anything that. Because it's like sniffing his underwear now that he's left the building. That's what this is.
Yeah,
like, she's one of these Trump people, and they're like their worst nightmare for all this like QAnon and Boogaloo's for all and the Proud Boys and you know for all that bullshit. They need that shit so bad. Like a person who's reasonable is a bigger enemy, especially to regular media. Here's what I've been through: if you have a thing that's a reasonable point,
yeah,
you'll be attacked harder than someone who's crazy even.
So if you say like, well, I mean, she's getting attacked hard and she has said some wild shit and her-
She's a lunatic. She's just so yeah. fucking-
Dude, she had to say that-
A congressperson-
She had to say 9/11 was real. Yeah. She had to say 9/11 was real.
She said it's not real or it is real?
I think she had like one of those Facebook posts that said it was like, she was like a 9/11 truther. And then she had to like come out in her committee hearing and be like, 9/11 did happen. It's just a funny thing for
were people arguing that it didn't actually happen? That sounds like saying the moon didn't happen. Like
I don't know, man. I don't
she
know
wasn't saying it was an inside job.
This lady seems like she pulled a lot from the batshit crazy buffet. Like she just went and was just like, oh, that's a good one, and then I'll put this on my plate too. And like
yeah, I've heard lunatics get up and say they believe a man named Jesus Christ lives in the sky. So I've heard crazy shit.
Yeah, you've seen.
I actually saw somebody get up and say they believe the first five books of the Bible are history.
That's crazy. That's crazy.
I heard
to say anything literal, like a literal belief in that, where they're like, "No, that definitely happened."
Yeah, there's some people that they there's Hindus are real. Like, it's just so funny to see where the line's drawn of crazy.
Yeah,
Jew lasers, like I mean. I always, and I'm not even trying to trash the Owens moon belief so much because I like that someone is saying that so I can laugh about it. Mm-hmm. I don't think it's dangerous, but somebody said to me one time about who's a basketball player that said he thought the earth was flat.
Oh, who was it? Who was the flat earther? It was,
Annie's brother's a sportscaster in Massachusetts. And he was saying, he's like, and he likes space.
Kyrie Irving.
Is it?
Yeah, it was Kyrie.
I just remember he goes.
It was when he played. It was when he was playing for the Cavs, and I think when he went to the Celtics.
So he said like we didn't land on the moon, and maybe the Earth is flat, and but the dude who's a sports fan and a space fan, he was like, that's dangerous. This is what I hate when people tweet. I'm like, that's not only is it it's actually probably the least damaging thing that's ever been put on Twitter to anything.
Yeah,
this basketball player doesn't. Who gives a fuck? But Kyrie. Thinks about, was he going to space tomorrow?
The history books are going to look back and realize he ruined science. Because
that guy ruined space.
Because he was twitching a game of NBA 2K and was like, I don't know, man. I don't think the moon's there.
I go, you think there's, like, first of all, why? What? Like, I'm surprised you care about space as a dumb jock.
Yeah.
What do you give a shit? Like, are really brilliant scientists going to give up on their science careers because they got discouraged by a basketball player?
Yeah, the Venn diagram of bleed over of jocks and people who love space is a very slim.
And that's slim, but however, people who love space that it matters how they feel about space is non-existent. Like the how you feel as an NBA player about the shape of the Earth affects absolutely not. You can believe in that there is a race of giants that the government's covering up.
Which there are.
And play professional, and it affects nothing. Also, you can be an actor and think that, and it affects nothing.
Zero.
But people expect you. They're like, you have a platform. That means it has to be what I say it is.
I would like
or else you're misusing your platform.
If I was friends with Kyrie Irving, I would want to know the crazy, like, death threats and shit talking that he got
He probably believes he was on the right track more than ever after the amount. Because I promise you, somebody, it's so funny, we used to trash, as America as a whole used to make fun of fundamentalist Islam for going crazy because you drew the prophet.
Yeah,
my God, you'd kill someone over that? You guys are so stupid. Meanwhile, in America, we'll fucking threaten to kill you for not believing in the moon.
Like, you don't believe in the moon? Like, I'll bomb your whole fucking city.
Yeah, America is like, oh, we give a death threat, an Islamic death threat, for literally every fucking thing. They're the most the fucking ISIS is more rational than us.
Yeah.
And they got some good ideas, and I want to get that across. I hope that's coming across.
Let me tell you about Donald Soup's new flavor.
Yeah.
It is our Middle East borscht.
Can you do a like a Ben and Jerry's where they have like, they make like admiration ice creams, but do it for ISIS?
Yeah.
Like an ISIS admiration soup, Ben and Jerry style?
We're going to be doing a beheaded butternut squash. We're going to be doing a bunch of different ones. We're going to be doing
Donald Soup, Black Forest, Jew Laser, dessert soup.
Yeah. We're going to be doing our lovely caliphate tomato soup, which is the blood, the streets will run bled with the blood of the infidels. We got a whole rollout campaign coming up.
The streets will run blood with the red of the soups. I'm trying to think of a good.
Our tomato soup, our infidel blood.
How about an AOC OnlyFans soup?
Oh, dude, that's pretty good.
Okay, wait. Now I remember why I brought up AOC. So you, that girlfriend thing you were saying is right. Like, I react to her like a girl. I'm like, all right, bitch. I know you're playing. Like, we dated. That's the gut reaction I had.
Yeah.
And I was like, so, because I've never looked for like porn. Like, remember when Sarah Palin, who's that porn star that we all know that was at Sirius? Remember Lisa Ann was Sarah Palin in a porno?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, one of the best of all time.
So who's the porn star playing AOC? And I looked it up, and because I looked up, I'm like, because at first I was like, oh, it's because she's a left wing, so you can't make her as a porn star.
Yeah.
No, it's not why. I mean, maybe it's why, but the main reason why is because they don't need a Lisa Ann anymore. As soon as I put in AOC porn, a million very good deep fakes of AOC sucking dick came up. The idea, I thought it was some kind of like deep political. Fake. Political thing? It's not. Lisa Ann's job is obsolete playing Sarah Palin getting fucked because you could just put Sarah Palin's fucking face on another porn star.
Wow, man.
And can I tell you something? The AOC porn looks a lot better than Luke Skywalker's face on The Mandalorian.
What happened with that? That was fucking terrible. That took me out of that scene.
And by the way, awesome. It was an awesome thing to do with Luke Skywalker.
It looked like,
does Disney hate Luke Skywalker that much? They're like, we're not paying for this.
Dude, it got blown, that reveal, if you didn't know, there's a spoiler for you, but in Mandalorian.
Oh, yeah. By the way, there's another thing. And this is the other thing I blame AOC's soccer flag reaction.
Yeah.
The original triggering of people, which is spoilers.
Yeah.
Don't, like, if you're an adult that's like, don't spoil it, you are a fucking loser.
Do you think
my empty life?
Don't do the thing.
How do you not, as an adult, if you're even gonna invest the time to watch a fucking thing, spoil it ahead of time to know it's worth watching?
Well, I would argue that I think there is a limited amount of time for spoilers.
I took a really harsh stand on spoilers.
You did. You really did. You actually did an all or nothing stance, and I just want to let everyone know.
Black and white thinking. That's a sign of insanity.
Donald Soups sees the gray. We see that gray in our new...
Try out our Earl Grey tea soup.
Yeah, that's what we're gonna do. Our new Earl Grey drink soup.
Yeah.
Some people call it tea. We call it drink soup. But
what does Donald Soups look like? Can I ask you?
Oh, I'm going to get a big, like, Jim the Anvil Nightheart goatee.
Oh, you have a goatee?
Yeah.
I was thinking that you have a warm turtleneck.
Sure, I'm fine with that. But I feel like there should be some hair to pull down famous enough that I have to move to try
maybe
my suits.
You have a beard with like a bow in your beard.
Yes. Can I go very Viking haircut? I'm playing Assassin's Creed Valhalla. So I would like to, I'm having fun with it. So I would like to have a Viking haircut.
You have like a beard and there's like a bow in it.
Yeah. Down. It's like crossed, you know, like down. And then I have to move it to try
and
my
then
suits.
What kind of hat? I was thinking you have some kind of hip hat with your hair poking out of the top.
Okay. All right, so it like kind of sits up. Do we do
yeah, like let's say it's a knit cap and your hair comes down, or you could do like a fucking Philip DeFranco, that guy on YouTube. He I wanted to reach through the screen and punch him in his fucking face for his
what hair. Does this guy look like? Bring okay, it up.
He looks he's just like a goof. Yeah, just you put Philip he had a backwards ball cap
okay.
with bangs pulled through the back and gelled down so they would stay.
Okay.
And then hair like not sideburns, just hair pushed down on the sides. Like if you took Garth Chris Gaines hair and put a backwards cap on it and pulled the Chris Gaines hair through the back.
Are you trying to pitch me on what Donald Soups' hair is going to be? Because this sounds fantastic.
Yeah, is you know, but then I don't know if the goatee works.
You're right.
I think you should
I'll
look something like Jack Dorsey.
Right.
Did you get a picture of Jack Dorsey of Twitter with his with his fucking rocker hair that he had? Do you know what I'm talking about, Joey? If you put Jack Dorsey image, it'll pop up. He had like that smeared down cotton candy okay. machine hair.
All right. I think there needs to be levels to the Donald Soups look. I think it needs to start with like when I'm getting the business off the ground, when we get our first celebrity, when I'm making a lot of money, when I do my first Super Bowl commercial, when I eventually get caught for having a mansion of Filipino 60-year-olds that I naked dog pile, then you find out about it.
Yeah, no, you're the Chris Gaines of soup.
Yeah, dude.
Fucking, oh, look, I think this is Donald Soup. Okay,
that's Donald Soup.
Dude, look at the very first.
Yeah, dude.
Look at this fucking dildo.
It looks like Brooks Wheelan going through it.
It looks like if John Mulaney was doing Chris Gaines.
Yeah. Like, hello, everyone. You ever want to see my jokes? I'm Christopher Gaines. You know, soup, the thing you know, that's liquid. Like a,
you know, like a clown.
You know, like a solid dipped in a liquid.
I can't. Kyle does them really well. I can't tell.
Oh, that. Man. Yeah. Look Kyle does hair. Everyone well.
Look at his nose. Okay. Donald Soup has a nose ring.
Yes. 100%. And that's how I know if I've ate too much soup is if I dip my nose ring in it. I went too far in.
Yeah. You know, and I could see the logo being like a silhouette of like a jacket like this.
Yes.
And like a beard, white and black contrasting, just an outline of a beard.
Yeah.
And a face. With a Donald Soups.
With just soup in the middle of the head, where the eyes would be. Just says soups.
Oh.
Yeah.
Like maybe maybe the head split and it says Donald's, like you're thinking of soups, maybe.
Ooh, all right. And now.
But I like this look for Donald Soups. I think
there will be our bread bowl march. That's where we're.
Oh, here's Bobby Hutch has a suggestion. He wears a hairnet.
On his chin when he's cooking the soups. You know what? I think that's his health department. Bobby Hutch is
dude,
right.
Yeah, you should have a hairnet on your beard for the soup because this is not good. This is the irony of Donald Soups is this beard, one of the worst for eating soup.
It's his gift is his curse. It's how he thinks as he strokes his goatee about his new soups, but he can't eat the soups.
There's always a little bit of beard in the soup. That's called the angel share.
If you get a whisker, you get a free bag of
there's
oyster
always a
crackers.
Yeah, there's always a whisker in the barrel of soup.
That's how you know it's good. If you got a yeah. Donald.
We make old-fashioned soup.
Excuse me, sir. There's a hair in my Hawaiian chicken noodle soup. And you go, you're welcome. You got two.
Hey, yeah, this ain't your mom's throwing soup. I think that.
You get a free mom's throwing soup. You got three hairs.
Do you like your soup with no pulp? Because that's not how we make soup.
Pulp. You want full pulp or no pulp?
This is Grove Stand style soup.
Yeah, this is going to be a thick one. This doesn't go down the kitchen sink drain.
I mean, if a beard hair bothers you, like I dip my balls in this. So
yeah, you're going to not be happy. We can pretty much pull a wig out of this thing.
Boy, I love this Donald Soups.
It's going to be a
alter ego.
Multi-million dollar idea.
I mean, Joey Roses, I was, as a sandwich guy, I like the name Joey Roses, but Donald Soups?
Yeah. Donald Soups is pretty good. Irish had a good point. There might be some special spice, though. This might be special spice is the goatee, a little dunk of the goatee. Look at those eyes. Look at those forgiving eyes.
Look at his eyes as he's pondering, like, do I have the right to stop people from tweeting? I think I do.
Look at the size of
the
right
beard. I have a lot. Just the idea that something as heavy as like free speech shit rests on the shoulders of this sack of shit. Look at this guy is the one who has to weigh whether or not what speech is okay. This fucking guy with this fucking nose ring. If he was making soups, I wouldn't talk this way about him. Donald Soups can look like this. And I'm like, that's where he belongs, making soup in a fucking truck.
Yeah.
Slowly growing his business, getting the hottest outstanding trans athlete today to promote that soup. That's cool.
If this guy asked me about free speech, I wouldn't trust his opinion. If he asked me about hot liquids, I would follow his lead.
If he wanted to tell me about hot liquids, he's welcome.
Welcome to. Look at that. Look at that fucking goat.
But the idea that this son of a bitch is in charge of anything.
I'm excited. I'm excited to get this off the do. We got a lot of calls to make. Lawyers, business managers.
Yeah, we've invented a new business and we can wrap up on that. I really am excited about this soup venture, I gotta say.
Man, I gotta call a lot of people.
Yeah, and I think the title is the Chris Gaines of Soup.
Yes. Chris Gaines of Soup is a perfect title for this. And man, we're about to start a lunch war with Joe DeRosa.
With Joey Rose's.
Yeah.
And get one thing straight, everybody listening, okay? Donald Soups and Dan Soder are ultimately the same guy. They're not two different characters.
They are not. It is just me living out the soup venture capitalist that is buried inside of me.
Can you believe this asshole actually said the question I get asked the most?
Hold
on. I think I didn't remember it right. Joey, will you just play that beginning thing about what I get asked the most? I just want to make sure I heard what I think I fucking heard.
What people ask me the most about Chris Gaines is his dong the same as my dong?
Are you just gay and you want to come out as gay in this country?
Is there something that you can't tell us? And to that I say...
And you sing hippie rock from the 60s.
Kiss my tip, I'm Chris Gaines.
Kiss my tip, I'm Chris Gaines. Was it the Vimeo? Was that what it was?
Yeah, it was Vimeo.
All right, I just want to hear that soundbite one more time. It was just really delightful.
Garth Brooks... is last question that I get about Chris Gaines is what's it like to play two different people? And the answer is, first, let's get one thing straight. I'm not playing two different players.
I'm not your friend. Don't touch me.
The Garth Brooks thing is just who I am.
Wait, press pause.
Let's get one thing straight. I'm not your buddy.
Let's get one thing straight. I paid you to watch you jerk it, not listen to you talk.
I don't want you asking me Chris Gaines questions while I'm watching you fucking...
Hey, I'm trying to get a nut here. Okay, press play.
Gaines thing, though, the closer you look and the more you find out, you realize Chris Gaines is Garth. So all it is a stretch. And all it is
that is the craziest.
Hey, wait a minute.
Son of a bitch, this trick. He goes, now, does that mean that Bugs Bunny isn't sexy when he dresses up like a lady? No. He goes, I can be Chris Gaines.
Wait, go back. Go back. I'm sorry.
I can be Chris Gaines and Bugs can be a sexy lady that wants to fuck Elmer Fudd.
Yeah, like you could have feelings for even though it's the same Bugs. All right, press play.
The same way we took a song from the 60s and the 90s and put them together to create a new song for the millennium. It's probably the crossroads where Garth and Chris meet dead on and probably the most they're alike. And a song called Right Now.
I hate it.
Press pause. So that's where they ultimately intersect at the
is the song Right Now?
At the intersection of horse and shit, they come together.
Yes, what you're gonna want to do is you're gonna want to take blow smoke up my ass avenue.
So down. Chris Gaines is down like this, and then Garth lowers himself on. He lowers his fat fucking sandwich ass on him.
Garth Brooks is driving fast down Highway to Success, and Chris Gaines is a deer that walks out onto the highway and stares at the incoming car. And then causes a quadriplegic life for Garth Brooks.
Oh my God. This is amazing. Dan Soder is the Garth Brooks who is the Chris Gaines, but of soup.
Oh man, I have so much money to spend when all my beard trimmings are in these people's
suits.
He's
been called the Chris Gaines of soup.
Dude, everyone says it.
Okay, well, Donald, anything to plug besides Donald Soup? Isn't Bonfire coming back?
Bonfire's coming back. When's this coming out?
I don't know. We might release this one before the other one even.
Well, Bonfire's coming back soon. So keep an eye out. Follow the Bonfire at the Bonfire SXM on Twitter and Instagram. DanSoder.com. I'm going to be a Columbus Funny Bone in 2 weeks. Now that I got those antibodies. And
look at you with his antibodies. Donald Soups has antibodies.
Yeah, he's got that's going to be one of our new soups. Antibodies. Make sure you check it out. It's for people that don't want to get in shape. Yeah, dude, thanks for having me. This was a fun one.
I must have really strong attracting feelings to AOC.
Dude, like, you got to think about it.
You made me think about soup. You made me think about looking up to see if AOC has foot porn.
Yeah, dude. Go see if she
my friend from high school texted me that. She's like, does she have an OnlyFans for feet or anything?
I mean, yeah, I can get on board with that, you know? A little fucking footsies. A little tootsie footsies.
A little tootsie footsies? Oh, she was so scared. Well, I had to reassure her by coming on her feet. all right, dude. So nothing else to promote besides Bonfire?
No, that's it. Bonfire and... you can watch my HBO special, Son of a Gary, on HBO Max.
Son of a Gary. Oh, sweet.
Son of a Gary.
That's pretty sweet.
Get through it. Go do the hour challenge with it.
Guys, people have been hitting me up on cameos, and I realize how hilarious this is. But I've had people ask me to, like give advice to a friend and shit on cameo. It was the funniest fucking thing.
Yeah.
This request, and I thoroughly enjoy it. So that's a great cameo. If you have some question for your friend that they need help with, I used to do a help column that was called a second opinion.
Yeah.
And what I do is I would take other people's columns and just take the questions and answer them.
You just wash it. You just launder it.
It was questions that were not asked to me. So yeah, it's like, can you tell my friend this or that? Somebody did that. Does that make sense how I'm describing it? It made me laugh my ass off. And
You're giving opinions of people's opinions.
Yeah, I think it's my... I mean, I'll do whatever you want on Cameo. I mean, anything.
Anything.
I'll say whatever the fuck you want. Damn. You want to talk about soup? We'll talk about soup. And other than that, promoting... the only thing I'd promote is these sketches with Kyle Dunnigan. Go to Kyle Dunnigan 1 on Instagram. And maybe friend me on Instagram. Your old pal. Pastor Kurt. I don't know what my cool Chris Gaines name is.
We're going to come up with it. That's going to be the next episode I'm on. We're going to come up with your Instagram follower.
Yeah, for my Instagram. And I'm not sure that it's an Instagram ministry, but it might be.
Might be.
I don't know how to make soup.
Yeah, either do I. I got to get a good
Anybody soup can guy. Fucking make soup. I mean,
yeah. I'm just more of the ideas guy. I got to get an actual guy that can, you know.
You need to get hair soup. Like Jack Dorsey, a beard like Jack Dorsey.
Done.
A fucking nose ring.
Done. And start slinging this fucking liquid.
And you're called Donald Soups, and you're wearing a nice jacket.
Yeah.
Oh, this is beautiful.
A lovely blazer.
Go on YouTube channel Kyle Dunnigan to watch the crack 'em ups and sillies we make. And I guess that's pretty much it.
Oh, yeah.
It's not a lot. I'm not anywhere doing stand up. I don't have antibodies. You think you're better than people because you have antibodies?
I'd be sick. I'd go through hell. I had to go through hell to get
this fucking typhoid Soder here doesn't care who he kills.
Stop it. That is not true. That is not true. I shut down the kissing booth immediately.
All right. That's our show, guys. Thanks, Dan.
Yeah, dude.
Thanks, Donald. Excuse me. Thank you, Donald Soups. I want to thank both of you for coming on.
Yeah, thank you. You can't thank one without the other.
Like, let's get it straight. I'm one guy playing two. What's it like to be one person and then act like a completely different person who's obviously that same original person?
I'll tell you right now, it's psychotic, and I love it.
All right, later, brother.
Later, dude. Because I can't get right. Because I can't get right. Yeah. You're listening to Can't Get